Government is a necessary part of life, because without government, life becomes a war against all. When the United States was deciding how to form its government, two different options were available. The division of power, or rule by a single sovereign. The Federalist thought prevailed, and so early federalism was built on the principle of dual sovereignty. Although the Constitution divided sovereignty between state and nation, with each in control of its own sphere, it was inevitable that power would eventually need to trade hands.
Thomas Jefferson's presidency was threatened by a hostile House of Representatives. States countered national government in the Revolution of 1800, threatening military force and using nullification to prevent national government from abusing its power. Continued conflicts pushed the southern states, which valued liberty and individual rights over a strong central state, to secede. This conflict over federalism thereby directly led to the bloody Civil War.
After the Civil War, federalism no longer meant dual sovereignty. The national government now had power over state governments. And with that military power, states were put in charge of economic development. And social reformers turned to the courts. Courts initially attempted to stick to the doctrine of dual sovereignty, but after Roosevelt's court packing scheme in the 1930s, the courts had a change of heart, broadening the coverage of the commerce and spending clauses. And after a landmark case in 1937 that ruled that Social Security was constitutional, the court has refused to review Congress's power to spend money.
Since this ruling, most national efforts to influence state governments come in the form of federal grants. In 1987, Congress provided a grant to state governments for the maintenance of their highways, but conditioned 5% of the funds on state willingness to raise drinking age from 18 to 21. In order for states to receive money for their projects, they must follow regulations placed on them by the federal government.
Although dual sovereignty is now thought of as a flawed policy, there is still a modern place for federalism. The national government still holds ultimate power, with a fair amount given to state and local governments. The very fundamentals of federalism continue to prove relevant. Federal government raises money through taxation and must have publicly elected officials. A federal government cannot operate independently, but relies on the input of its many factions.
Although flawed, federalism has nevertheless served as a vital slice of our government's structural pie, and will continue to be so for years to come. As Hamilton himself said, the vigor of government is essential to the security of liberty.